imagine there's no heaven. It's easy if you try. No hell below us, above us only sky.
Where do you get your moral code from?
My moral code? Oh, I know exactly where, because when I was 10 years old, I inadvertently witnessed my mother's adultery on the front seat of a car while I was supposed to be asleep on the back seat, which subsequently led to my parents getting divorced.
There are enough Sikhs in Britain to fill the Royal Albert Hall 100 times over. Many wear bright coloured clothes, play loud music, and never cut their hair. Quite a lot carry daggers in public. So what do we have to do to get noticed?
And then, of course, they tried to push me into being an altar boy or joining the choir. And so I think from about 9, 10, I started to perfect an anti-voice. And so I deliberately learned how not to sing, which put me in good stead years later, didn't it?
Drive down any major road in Britain today and you're likely to see a lamppost or railings covered in flowers, teddy bears and even football shirts. So who's creating these shrines at the roadside? And when and why did we start putting our grief on public display? Back in Victorian days, mourning was very much a public affair. You had to dress in certain clothes and behave according to a strict and complicated code of etiquette.
His time off from studying, he spends organising religious, cultural and social events. And there is a fair amount of alcohol involved too.
We have the greatest event of the year. We've got 7,000 shots of vodka. It's Booze for Jews!
I'm gonna lay down all my burdens down by the riverside. Ain't gonna study war no more.
All of these thousands of people with their hands up going, help us. Mm. I couldn't get these people. That's what I feel guilty about. I don't feel guilty that I stole the bus, but the fact that I couldn't get more people out, that really hurts me.
In 2004, the British population spent over £1.5 billion on hair care. So it seems obvious to me that it's something that's pretty important to us. How you wear your hair is about much more than just physical appearance. A hairstyle reflects who you are and sometimes what you believe.
Give me a head with hair, long, beautiful hair.
Sikh comedian Sodhi Singh Carlon puts on a turban to protect his long hair. Because of his faith, he's never had a haircut in his life.
This is Amsterdam, a low-rise city built on a human scale and best explored by water, on foot, or on your bike.
Bicycle, bicycle, bicycle.
I want to ride almost. Cut my hair.
And Martin, I've just seen you have your hair cut. Has that got any religious significance for you?
Well, not really, not in the serious sense, but it is almost of religious significance. I quite like the change it brings about, and I quite like letting my hair grow a bit and then having it cut really short and sort of quite a brutal act. It's almost like purging myself.
Did I disappoint you or let you down? Should I be feeling guilty?
Confession, it seems, works. It can be an emotional and spiritual experience, as artist Charlie Mackesy discovered when he used the confessions of 300 students to produce an extraordinary sculpture.
I do sculptures and I have made the odd crucifixion, but the idea of physically combining people's confessions into a body was one that I've been thinking through. And so when I came to do it, I just had buckets of plaster, wood, and I made the body out of the plaster and the wood and the crucifixion. And as I was doing it, people would come and write confessions on paper, which would then be put into the wet plaster, which would then be put into the body.
And I will fill my soul. time when I'm kneeling at your feet.
You could feel the intensity of emotion connected with confession and prayer and all that stuff.
My early experience of confession was surrounded with guilt and with dread, rather ludicrously so. I mean, what sins, realistically, can a seven-year-old have? And I think that was a shame, because it cut me off from the benefits of confession for many, many years. All I can say is that I'm glad that later in life, I found my way back to that simple proposition of sharing with another human being the things that make you most ashamed. It is a route to some kind of peace of mind.